Aloha, ladies and gentlemen. Once again, I'd like to thank my son, Michelangelo Barquez, your son, for being here, doing the hard work. Today, I'd like to just share some Poe Mo'olelo. Poe Mo'olelo. I'd like to just acknowledge Gary Taiping. He's the one that taught me my Kiwalo in the tarot patch. He passed away. So his funeral is coming up on the 20th. I'd like to thank Brother Gary. He's the one that taught me his the slack key, sincerely. His father was a guitar player too. And I'd like to thank Gilberto Martinez for teaching me my beloved song that I love, Evergreen. He told me to do it in the key of A because of the open string. Mahalo, Gilbert. I really appreciate you, my kumu. And the next one is I'd like to say aloha to my brother Joseph Guillermo over in New Mexico. And I thank God for my brother. He's the one that took me to Molokai, taught me how to drive, and had me to play bantam football for the Kaneohe Bantams. Yeah, I really appreciate Brother Joe. Well, let's get on with today's lesson. Today's lesson, basically, we're dealing with the jazz workshop. And at the end of the piece that I did, I demonstrated some of it here. Now, this lesson is for virtuosos, experts, intermediate. For the beginners in elementary, just observe and write down what you got over here, okay? Let's start with the chord chemistry. I got that from Don Mock from the Guitar Institute of Technology in Los Angeles. We brought him down here to do a concert in the 83. And he did at the Copeland Park, the first annual guitar festival. Well, in chord chemistry, what we're dealing with here, and you're going to recognize this, is the C, C sharp, D, D sharp, E, F, F sharp, G, G sharp, A, A sharp, B, C. What is that? Yes, that's correct. It's the C chromatic scale. It's the 12-tone scale. Notice our starting point starts at zero. Okay, now, this is the mother of the all scales. From the chromatic scale, we have the major scale. And what we're doing here is you're computing the distance from note to note. We're doing calculations, major scale formulas. We're doing formulas, you're computing the distance from note to note. And then what we're going to have, we have two distinct scales. We have the chromatic scale and the major scale. So the major scale, when we call them the major scale, it starts off on the root, okay? From in the beginning, right? God created the heaven and earth. Starts on the beginning. Okay, and it goes root 2-2-1, 2-2-2-1. This is a major scale formula. Starting on C, two half steps is D. Okay, C, C sharp, D. The two half steps from D is E. One from E is F. Now, from C to F is five half steps. That's called a perfect fourth. Then we go F to G, which is a major second. That's that's the link. And that perfect fourth is connected to this perfect fourth, G. To A is two half steps, A to B is two half steps, and B to C is one half step. So the major scale formula is root 2-2-1, 2-2-2-1. You put your finger anywhere and you can play this. You'll have Do, Re, Mi, Fa, Sol, La, Ti, Do. Going back is joy to the world. Okay, so what we have here is the Arabic numbers going here, Arabic numbers here, okay? Now, when you go to chords, since this is mathematical, in understanding, basically what we need to do is show you some symbols. So the symbols I'm showing you here is this delta, and that means major seven, and then we have the minor seven, which is a slash, and the small m, that means minor seven. Okay, and then we have the regular dominant seven chord. So here we have the Roman numeral system. This is one major seven. This is a two minor seven. Okay, this is the three minor seven, four major seven, the five seven. This is the six minor seven, the seven minor seven flat five, that's a half diminished, and back to C, C major seven. Okay, so what we have here is, this is basically the Ionian mode, the Dorian mode, the Phrygian mode, the Lydian mode, the Aeolian mode, with Ionian, Dorian, Phrygian, Lydian, Mixolydian, Aeolian, Locrian, and back to Ionian again. Now all that is from C to C is Ionian, D to D is Dorian, E to E is Phrygian, F to F, that's Lydian, G to G is Mixolydian, A to A is Aeolian, and B to B is Locrian, and back to C to C. And you're moving on to the second octave, and you're doing the same thing. That's basically what it is. Here's the symbols. Right here, that's delta, the major seven. Okay, and then the minor seven, the small m equals minor, or a slash means minor. If you have a capital M, that means major. Now, the circle seven means minor seven flat five. That's a half diminished. Why am I showing you this? Because this is the calculus, the algebra, the geometry of music. This is the math of music. This is the addition, subtraction, the division, and multiplication of music, and also the geometry of music. The geometry is the different designs. It's the trails, it's the lines, it's the movable patterns that's all movable. So basically, we have a major scale formula, and we have the seven, which is a seven-tone scale. Now, with that said, I'd like to move on to... Why am I showing you this? I'm showing you this because of the major scale. We have the key of C major. We have chord chemistry. Now we have, the word is superimposed. I got them from Mr. William Valdez, chord on chord. The first degree is a C major seven. It's 1-3-5-7. The second degree is D minor seven. It's D, F, A, C. The third degree is E minor seven. That's E, G, B, D. The fourth degree is F major seven, F, A, C, E. The G7 is the fifth degree, G, B, D, F. A minor seven is the sixth degree, A, C, E, G. B minor seven flat five is the seventh degree. And back to the first degree, 1-3-5-7. Okay, C major seven is 1-3-5-7. Here are the formulas. D minor seven formula is 1-3-5-7. The E minor seven, same thing, 1-3-5-7. Major seven, 1-3-5-7. Same like this, C major seven. They all have the same. Major seven has the same formula, it carries over. The dominant seven has 1-3-5-7. The A minor seven is 1-3-5-7. We have three minor sevens. We have two major sevens in this key center, and we have one dominant seven, and we have one minor seven flat five. The minor seven flat five with the half diminished is 1-3-5-7. Okay, to superimpose, why am I showing you this? Because you can superimpose a C major seven, which is C, E, G, B, against the E, G, B, D, and you have a C major 9 chord. If you look over here very carefully, C, E, G, B, can you see E, G, B, D? Can you see the common tones? All you're doing here is you're adding the ninth, you're adding the D. And I did take the time to write it out over here. Here's a C major scale in two octaves, C, D, E, F, G, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, A, B, C. C is 1, D is 2, E is 3, F is the fourth degree of the major scale, G is the fifth degree, A is the sixth, B is the seventh degree, C is the eighth degree. Okay, then move on to D, which is the ninth degree, E is the 10th, F is the 11th degree, G is the 12th degree, A is the 13th degree, B is the 14th degree, and C is the 15th degree. In other words, the second is the ninth, the fourth is the 11th, the sixth is the 13th. Okay, it's right there. Once again, the second is the ninth, the fourth is the 11th, the sixth and the third is the 13th. Forgive me for going too fast. I'm just concerned about the time. Okay, so what did we just do? We simply superimpose the C major 7 against the E minor 7, right? Okay. The next one is the right over here. When you superimpose the C major 7 against an A minor 7, the one, this is the one against the 3, you have a C major 9. This is the one against the 6 degree. Then we have a C major 13 or C6. But here's a formula, CEGB, 1, 3, 5, 7, C major 7. A minor is ACEG, 1, flat 3, 5, flat 7. See the CEG over here? Okay, so you're adding an A to this C major 7, and that equates to a C major 13. Remember, the 6 is the 13. Okay, now when you superimpose, what you can superimpose, an F major 7 against a D minor 7. F major 7 is spelled F-A-C-E, 1, 3, 5, 7. D minor 7 is D-F-A-C, 1, flat 3, 5, flat 7. That equates to an F minor 6 or an F minor, F major 6 or F major 13. What you're dealing with here, you have the major 7 here, okay, and the D minor 7. So you're adding you got F-A-C-E, D, F, A, C. So this one here, you're adding the D, which is the 6 degree. F, A, C, E, D is what occurs, what you're creating in chemistry. Finally, you can superimpose the 5, 7, which is the G major, the G7, which is G, B, D, F, 1, 3, 5, flat 7, against the B minus 7, flat 5, which is the half diminished. It's 1, B is the 1, D is the flat third, F is the flat five, and A is the flat seven. A nice man, he gave me the information. The B minor seven flat five is the first inversion of G9. But that's basically what I got from him, and I appreciate that. He is absolutely correct. Okay, now don't worry about it for those who don't understand what this is. Once again, I said this is for the experts and the virtuosos. F-A-C-E-D, 1, 3, 5, 7, 13 in the 6, so it's F major 13. When you superimpose an F major 7 against a D minor, and then you have a G9, when you superimpose a G7 against a B minor 7 flat 5, scaled in 2 octaves. C major 7 plus A minor 7 is a C major 13 or C6. So, let me show you. Can I have the guitar again, please? Let me show you what I did. The song I did was called The Shadow of Your Smile. That was arranged by Mr. William Van Wildes. So the ending part. On E minor. So against the E minor, what can I play against the E minor? The C major 7, right? So here's the E minor. I hit the E minor bass, and I hit the C major 7. I hit the E minor, and it can also play the A minor 7, remember? The C major 7 you can superimpose against the A minor. That's equivalent to the E minor 7. C major 7, E minor 7, and A minor 7 are 1. So here's the low E, A minor 9. E minor, A minor 9, E, A minor 9, E, C major 7, E, E minor, E, E minor 7. So that's what I mean. Thanks, son. Who uses this? Benny Chong uses this on this island. Number Swan does this. Eric Watanabe does this. Mike Marquez, we do it. Teachers on the mainland, Oscar Peterson, all those people, that's what they're doing. They're superimposing, playing chord on chord. Otherwise, if you do it the other way, it's either going to be folk music, or it's going to be Hawaiian contemporary or country. Now, the country chords is basically, instead of C major 7, it's just C, D minor, E minor, F, G 7, A minor, B minor, and flat 5, and then C. Without the 7, it's just three part harmony. Okay, so then we have a major scale in two octaves. Okay, so we have, where's the eraser? Okay, here's the eraser. Everybody, I'm taking this out. So the word is superimposed chord on chord, okay? Okay. All right. So now let's move on. Where's my pens? I need a good pen here. Now what I'm doing right now, I'd like to introduce to you the double sharp. So I'm introducing the double sharp. Now, once you get what I gave you, because I gave you the circle of fourths and all the different vignettes, you can do this. Watch. C, C sharp, and C flat. C equals 1, 3, 5. 1, 3, 5. 1, 3, 5. What do they all have in common? All 1, 3, 5, right? This is a major triad. These are all major triads. T-R-I-A-D-S. So the C major is C, E, G. The C sharp is C sharp, E sharp, G sharp. The C flat is C flat, E flat, and G flat. So analyze that. What you're doing now is computing the distance from note to note. The next one is D, F sharp, A. Then we have D flat, F, A flat. And then we have D sharp. And then here we have the F double sharp and A sharp. This equals D, this equals D flat, this equals D sharp. When you analyze this, then you can see how it makes sense. The next one is E, G sharp, all major triads, B, okay? Next one is E sharp, and this is a G double sharp. Notice the sharp, when you make it higher, the G sharp turns into a double sharp, and the natural turns into the sharp. So this is E, this one here is E sharp, and then of course we have the E flat, G, B flat. This is the E flat chord. Okay, let's move on. Moving on to the F chord, you can play this back. F equals F, A, C. F sharp equals F sharp, A sharp, C sharp. F flat equals F flat, A flat, B flat. Yes, indeed, they're all 1, 3, 5, 1, 3, 5, 1, 3, 5 of their respective scales. F scale, F sharp scale, F flat scale. Okay, so the F flat scale has one double flat. So there's F flat, A flat, and then F flat is one double flat. B double flat, F A C, F sharp A C sharp, F flat A flat. It's a C flat. Okay, that's the same thing. F sharp, F flat, A flat, C flat. Okay, next one is G. 7 equals G B D. Seven. It's a major chord. Next one is G sharp, B sharp, D sharp. And then we have G flat, B flat, and D flat. This is 1, 3, 5, 1, 3, 5, 1, 3, 5, G flat, B flat, and D flat. So this is G, this is G sharp, this is G flat. Okay, G sharp, B sharp. G sharp is one double sharp, F double sharp. Now G sharp, this is G flat, is okay, G flat, F, B flat, E flat, A flat, D flat. G flat is 6 flats. Okay, B flat, E flat, A flat, D flat, G flat, and C flat. So this is correct. Okay, the next one is A, C, because A, C sharp, E. That's A. A flat is A flat, C, E flat. The A sharp is A sharp, C double sharp, and E sharp. Okay, once again, they're all 1, 3, 5 of the respective scales. 1, 3, 5, 1, 3, 5. So what do they all have in common? It has the same chord formula. This is done in tertian harmony, meaning it moves in threes. I did that on another vignette. Finally, we have this final one. B equals B, D sharp, F. B flat equals B flat, D, F. And B sharp equals B sharp, D double sharp, but this is an F sharp, and then F double sharp. Okay, I'm going really quickly, so I'm concerned about the time. So basically, we got this from Pythagoras, the island of Ionia in Samos. He came up with a tertian harmony, and the tertian harmony basically is going up in 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 13. That's seven different numbers. So we have the triads in the key of A. Gilberto Martinez, he told me to do the song. He showed me the song Evergreen in there because of the open A. And basically, well, I'd like to ask you now, how, what, why, where, and when? Always ask them. Great minds ask great questions. Number one, how do we apply this? Well, like I said, you know, if it's country or Hawaiian music, don't do this. Don't use that. Just keep it square. Keep it regular. You can get fired if you go outside. This is inside. If you're doing jazz, then it's okay. Where do they play jazz? New York, Los Angeles, you know, Miami, Hawaii, you know. Over here, we do jazz too. Now, what are we doing? We're superimposing chord against chord in the same key. They're all relative. The DNA is the same. Why are we doing this? To create jazz. Just move on to a different genre. When do we use it? You can use it at the proper venue. You don't want to use this when you're playing Hawaiian music or country. Keep it square. Keep it the same. And where do we play this? At the right venue, or you can do this when you're practicing. Okay, here's what we're doing. You're learning the calculations. Number two, you're learning the major scale formulas. Number three, you're computing the distance from note to note in half steps. And number three, you've discovered that there are how many distinct key centers? Major, F major, F sharp, and F flat. Basically, that's what it is, okay? Do you have any questions? You know, please feel free to contact me somehow. Okay, we're at Nico's on Wednesday. We're gonna be there on the 19th. Nico's, please feel free to come over and we can talk story. Once again, we're introducing the double sharp. And with that said, I'd like to thank my son, Michelangelo, for doing a good job on the camera. Okay, kamsahamnida, shesheni, grazie, kaman, gaman, mahalo anui nui loa, arrivederci, mercy, ho'olohe, ho'oko, holomua, practice, listen, ho'olohe, listen, practice, ho'oko, and succeed, holomua, aloha nui.